an internal memo came from the publisher a few weeks ago offering everybody at the newspaper a voluntary severance package. They were told they needed to reduce the payroll. And, you know, it was pretty generous, and it coincided with my timing. I've been doing two jobs for 12 years now, doing the comic strip zits and five or six editorial cartoons every week. And that's a big workload. It's a fun workload, and I don't want to make it sound like it's not digging ditches, but it's you know, a lot of late nights and a lot of long weekends, and my family was ready for me to have a saner lifestyle, and I'm ready for it too. So anybody who follows our industry can see that this is everywhere. The Inquirer is not an exception this way. Newspapers are changing. It's a big period of transition. Everybody's trying to understand where the news business is going, and you can feel it here every day, and you have for a long time, because I think the Inquirer's been pretty forward thinking about all this. We no longer call ourselves a newspaper. We think of ourselves as an information center, and the information is disseminated many ways, you know, on the web and who knows what in the future. So it's not a surprise that as circulation declines, newspapers have to figure out how they're going to make it. And in within my little profession, my sub-profession of editorial cartooning, that train's been coming down the track for a while now. When I started in this field, there were 350 editorial cartoonists in America, and now I'm told there are something like 60 of us left. It's one of those jobs that a newspaper can do without by using syndicated work. Not to give the impression the Inquirer wanted me to leave. They, in fact, asked me to do a new kind of feature just to keep up some kind of association with the readers and the paper, which we'll be figuring out in the weeks ahead and launching sometime later in the year. But I've always felt very wanted and very appreciated here, and so it wasn't so much about me, but the profession itself is evaporating before our eyes, and I find myself wondering what's going to happen to editorial cartooning. I just have to believe that people have an appetite for social and political commentary in a graphic form. It seems very fundamental to me. And if people no longer get it through still black and white images on newsprint, I have to think they'll be looking for it, you know, on TV or on the web. I think Jon Stewart and The Daily Show and, you know, the late night comedians, and there's probably stuff on the web that I'm not so familiar with, but all the sardonic and sarcastic commentary that's out there, it'll survive in some form. It just might not be on newsprint the way we've been used to it. I kind of feel like an old married couple with this town. You know, we sit down together over breakfast and have done it every day for 32 years, and sometimes we have a lot to say, and sometimes we have a little to say. But one way or another, I'm always there, and you're always there. And this is going to be new for me, and I guess for everyone who enjoys that same ritual. I don't know how much I'm going to miss this. There are times when I get my fill of politics and think I'd love to just read the paper without a highlighter in my hand see what's going on in the world in the same way that everybody else does, and not think about what I'm going to do with it that day. On the other hand, I know the day isn't too far off when I see a story and an idea comes to my mind, and I may not have the same forum now to express my thought. And I suspect there are some twinges ahead as I get used to that. I will have this new feature on Sundays, and I can't talk about it much because it's not really formed in my mind, but I do value the relationship I have with this town, and so we'll be thinking about some way to keep talking. You know, we often don't know what we mean to people. I don't just mean in the news business, I mean in general. And I come in here, and my job every day is to fill this paper with something that I hope will be interesting to people. where they take it, what they do with it, whether they take it into their hearts or kick it out the door, I really don't know much about that part of it. So we'd all like to think we'll be missed. It's a nice thought, and I appreciate your words. The idea behind doing what I've done all these years is to engage the readers, hopefully in an enjoyable way, with whatever is going on in the news. Whatever's going on in our world, let's talk about it. In the belief that whether we end up agreeing or disagreeing is almost irrelevant. It helps you figure out where you stand. It helps me figure out where I stand. And if we're all doing that in an active way, we're going to make better decisions as a city and as a country. And that's been the spirit behind this all these years. So engaging with the issues, engaging with the debate, the great American debate, is what this has all been about. And people are going to continue to do that. I'll just be on a different side of the debate. I'll be on a less visible side of the debate, I suppose. You know, I have my favorites. I suppose they're not ones that most people would think of. It's mainly because I tackled a certain drawing challenge that I found, challenging and managed to pull it off or something like that. But the ones that other people have liked are the ones that really log into my mind. I think of the Bengals tiger sprawled across the field saying next. You know, it's been a long time since we've been able to roll that one out. But and when Ryan White, the boy with AIDS, died and went, I drew him in heaven, or when Nuxall died, or the flying pigs or Marge shot people. These are the ones people recall to me. And you hang around long enough, people do. You cover a lot of turf, and it's been 32 years of this town's life and this country's life. One way or another, I've tried to put it down on paper. When I'm really ready, when I've got an idea, I get out my good paper and draw the rectangle that it has to fit inside of. I usually go to Google image search and find photographs of Sarah Palin or whoever the new character on the stage is. Put those out across my screen and start drawing, and it usually takes 3 or 4 or 5 or 10 attempts to get from a kind of a portrait-like drawing to a caricature. And of course, if you get that character on the stage for a while, like 4 or 8 years, like a president or a mayor or somebody, then the caricature gets a little further and further from reality and takes on a life of its own, and you get wonderful characters like Marge Schott, who almost seem like they were born on the comics page. I grew up just devouring editorial cartooning, and I watched the line work on the cartoonists whose work I love, the way, a musician listens to a symphony or something. To me, it's always really, those drawings sing. And as there are fewer and fewer people doing it, and I see fewer and fewer young people coming up in it too, I can't help but wonder where it's all going. But, that's the way of the world. That's the way, I bet half the people listening could say that about their profession. Everything's changing. And, you have to be adept and change with it, or know when it's your time to move on.